So there are three kinds of polarization: linear, circular, and elliptical. And we've seen what are the necessary and sufficient conditions for achieving this polarization. Okay. So for linear polarization, we can have either one orthogonal component or two of them. So if two orthogonal linear components exist, then there should be a phase difference of 180 degree or multiple of that. So that is the condition for achieving linear polarization. Okay. Same, if we have been going with circular polarization, then we must need, so for this case there should not be any requirement of having two orthogonal components of equal magnitude. So that is the not a necessary condition to have the equal amplitude for each of the orthogonal component, that is magnitude should not be same, so there will be no problem with that. But when we have been going with circular polarization, there should be two orthogonal component within the field, whatever the fields, that is electric field we are considering, there should be two orthogonal components, and the condition is that it should have the same magnitude and the phase difference must be odd multiples of 90 degree. Now depending upon the propagation, either it is in the plus z or minus z, we can have either clockwise or counterclockwise. So for this case, whether the for our consideration, for this case we have considered the wave has been propagating in the minus z direction. So for that case, if the phase difference is positive, it will considered as clockwise, that is right hand. If it is negative, it will be considered as the counterclockwise or left hand. So in this way we will identify, and the elliptical polarization, only the difference is that the magnitude should be different. For the two orthogonal components, the magnitude should be different, that is axial ratio should not be 1. So that is the condition for achieving elliptical polarization. Okay, so by saying this, we'll start with some problems. So we need to identify whether this is the linear polarization, circular polarization, or some other polarization, that is elliptical polarization. So let us go with some problem. First problem is writing the electric field vector. It is given as 20 sine omega t minus beta z ax cap plus 30 sine omega t minus beta z ay cap. So I am just writing the equations, that is expressions for the field vector. You just try to identify which polarization is this. Second one, 20 cos omega t minus beta z ax plus 20 sin omega t minus beta z ay. Third one, 50 sin omega t minus beta z ax cap. So it is az cap plus 30 cos omega t minus beta z az cap. Fourth one, 40 cos omega t minus beta z ax cap plus 50 sin omega t beta z ay cap. Fifth one, real of ay cap plus 2j az cap e to the power j omega t minus beta x. Sixth one, e is equals to 30 sine omega t minus beta rho a phi cap. Seventh one is 40 cos omega t minus beta r a theta k. So let us go with the first one. So just try to understand the expression, what are the different information is given. So if we look into this, we have two orthogonal components. The magnitudes are different. Whether there is any phase shift, so it is also sine, this is also sine. So it will be the linear polarization, because the necessary condition for achieving linear polarization is that either 180 degree or multiple of 180 degree. So here the n is 0, same phase. The magnitude of the two orthogonal components are different. So we can say it is linear polarization. Any doubt with this? Anyone? Any doubt? Two orthogonal components exist, they are of different magnitude, the phase difference is multiple of 180 degree. So here n is equals to 0. So we can write it is as linear polarization. Any confusion, anyone? If you go with second one, again two orthogonal component exist, but they are of same magnitude and phase difference is of 90 degree, right? Phase difference is of 90 degree, one is cos, another is sine. So it is circular polarization, right? It is of circular polarization. Next, third one. So I am just leaving this third one up to you. You just try to identify which one is this. Fourth one, it is different amplitude, it is 40. Magnitude is different, right? But the phase difference is 90 degree. Two orthogonal component, phase difference is 90 degree, but the magnitude is different. So we can say it is elliptical polarization. Fifth one, we need to go with the real value of this, right? So if we have been going with the real value, so here cos plus j sin, so this cos will come with ay and this az will go with sin. Just try to think, if we expand this one, so there will be cos and sin. Sin is the imaginary, and here az associated with the imaginary value. So this imaginary and sin will become real, and here ay with cos. So one is cos, another is sin. Magnitude is different. So what will be that? One is 1, first this cos component is having magnitude 1, sin component is having the magnitude of 2. So it is again elliptical polarization. Next, single orthogonal component always will be linear polarization, right? Single component means always a linear polarization. Now my question is on the third. Just try to figure out which polarization is this for this third expression. Anyone? Or if anyone having any doubt within this, you can ask. Third one.
Elliptical, sir.
Yes, elliptical. How? Okay, anyone else? magnitude is different and sine and cos component. Anything else we need to consider?
Sir, linear.
Linear why?
And both are az components.
Both are az component. Okay. Anyone having any other thinking? You have got the point, you have picked the point, but you have not justified that one. You have not thinked about that point. You have picked that point that both are in the az component, but you have not thought at all about this point. You have picked the one, the correct one. You have just had the target point. First of all, whenever any expression is given, we need to find out whether is it a valid expression or not. So what we know, there should not be any filled component along the direction of propagation. Here the wave is propagating along the z, the component is also exist along the z. How it is possible? For every other expression, we are having the filled component in other direction compared to the direction of wave propagation. But for this expression, it is given az. So it is not at all a valid expression itself. It is not a valid electric field expression. Okay. So first of all, you need to check out whether the expression is correct or not. Anyone having any doubt with this linear, circular, elliptical, how it is? Now, when we have been thinking about this antenna, there are two factors we need to consider. One is known as, with respect to this polarization. Polarization means orientation. How these fields are oriented. Either they are horizontally oriented, either they are vertically oriented. So depending upon that, the waves, how these waves have been coming out from the antenna. So obviously, if the waves have been coming out, it is having the horizontal orientation. So obviously, the antennas are also like that. Means antennas are supporting that orientation because the antenna are the source of that wave. So depending upon this polarization, when a communication is going on between two antenna, that is one is transmitter and another is receiver. So obviously, for having better communication or better transmission and reception, two antennas must be having same kind of orientation or polarization. So if we are having these two antennas, this is horizontally oriented, this transmitter, this, if this receiver is also horizontally oriented, then whatever the waves will be propagated or transmitted from this transmitter, the best reception will take place. Now, if this is horizontally oriented and this is vertically oriented, then the reception will be completely zero because the waves are horizontally oriented. The antenna is vertically oriented. So this orientation is completely different. So we must need to have the knowledge about the orientation of this transmitter and receiver. We must need to have the knowledge. So depending upon this orientation among the antennas, there are two factors we need to consider. One is called copolarization and second one is known as cross polarization. One is copolarization and that is cross polarization. So copolarization means collinear, means they are having the same orientation. Either this transmitter or receiver, both of them having the same orientation. Cross means different. So whenever there is polarization matching happens, maximum reception can be possible. Whenever the polarization mismatch happens, the reception will be minimum or the least. So depending upon the orientation, if these two antennas are having the same, I'm just drawing a simple antenna, something like that. So same, if the other antenna is having the same kind of orientation, then you can think of that the maximum reception can be possible. Like this. Now, if this orientation is different, that is one is horizontal, one is vertical, like this, if it is somewhat like this, then we can say there is mismatch in the orientation. So this is the case of the copolarization, this is the case for the cross polarization. So depending upon this polarization, the transmission and reception, we can find out a factor known as polarization loss factor. That is, due to this mismatch in the polarization, how much power is get received in the transmitter, in the receiving antenna from the transmitter, how much power is get received. Okay, so this loss factor, it is commonly known as polarization mismatch, because it is after a loss. So if there is certain mismatch, obviously loss will happen. Okay, so let us consider the electric field from the incoming wave. Assuming the electric field of the incoming wave EI, it is some unit vector in some direction, and it is the fraction of, let us give this prime, of the total incoming electric field. So what is this rho w? It is the unit vector of the incoming vector, incoming wave. Incoming wave. Now, this is about the incoming wave, that is the transmitter antenna. This is the situation being observed at the transmitting antenna. Now, at the receiving antenna, that is polarization of the receiving antenna. EA prime, it is having some unit vector into EA, that is unit vector, or these are known as polarization vector, means it defines some direction from which direction these waves are been coming or transmitting, vector or polarization vector. Now, this polarization loss can be taken into account by introducing the polarization loss factor. So, what is this polarization loss factor? PLF is equals to mod of these two unit vectors and their square. So, these unit vectors are identifying or giving some fraction of the either incoming signal, that is electric field, or the transmitting electric field. So if we take into consideration of this dot product means we are taking the cos value. So why this is dot? Because we need to find out the orientation, either they are having the same orientation or not, or this square will signify that we are considering the power. So that is cos psi p whole square. So what is this psi p? So we need to go with the direction. Let us consider this is the transmitting direction, this is the receiving direction. Now if this angle psi p, if it is zero, then we can have the maximum reception. Means this incoming signal is having the, this receiving signal or at the receiver orientation is having the same orientation of the transmitting wave, right? So if we are having this psi p is equals to 0, then we can have this PLF is equals to 1. Okay, so we can say that if the polarization is matched, then there will be maximum power reception. If this psi p is 90 degree, that is in the different direction, the transmitting antenna is oriented in different direction compared to the incoming wave, then there will be no reception. We'll solve some problem with that. Now depending upon this polarization loss factor, we can have the polarization efficiency. So what is this polarization efficiency? It is the ratio of the power received by an antenna from a given plane wave of arbitrary polarization to the power that would be received by the same antenna from a plane wave of the same power flux density and direction of propagation, same flux density and direction of propagation, whose state of polarization has been adjusted for a maximum power, for a maximum received power. So what is this? It is a ratio of the power received by an antenna from a given plane wave of arbitrary polarization. So for the receiving antenna, let us consider the polarization is not known. So it gives us the ratio of the power received by an antenna from a given plane wave, that is from a transmitter, of arbitrary polarization to the power that would received by the same antenna from a plane wave of same power flux density and a direction of propagation, whose state of polarization has been adjusted for the maximum power received. So what does it mean? It takes the comparison. So this polarization efficiency means the amount of reception when the state of polarization is known and when the state of polarization is unknown. So it is the ratio of the power received from an unknown polarized polarization, for an unknown polarization case and for a known polarization case. That is, first case, that the polarization is not known, how much power is get received, and second case, the polarization is known, power is received. So if you take the comparison of between these two, we can have this polarization efficiency. Okay, so first thing is that polarization is unknown, given plane wave arbitrary polarization, and second case, same power flux density and direction of propagation. We know this, the state of polarization. But for the both case, the power flux density and the direction of propagation is same. Okay, so whatever the antenna is used here for receiving an arbitrary polarized wave, and the same antenna, same power flux density and direction of propagation, that is our receiving antenna is focused at the same direction. Okay, has been adjusted for the maximum power reception. So if you take the comparison, we can have this polarization efficiency. So it is given by rho E, that is mod of L E dot E incident by L E square E incident square. So what is this L E? L E is the vector effective length of the antenna. Vector effective length of antenna. Okay, so how much effective length has been used for receiving the power, and EINC is the incident electric field. Okay, now for this case we have been taken the dot product, but for this case we have not taken the dot product. Why? Because for this case the polarization is matched, that is psi p is 0. So a dot b, it is ab cos theta, theta is known, so that will be a to b. But for this case psi p is not known, right? So this is the comparison. Here polarization is unknown, here the polarization is known, and we have taken the square to have the power, that is polarization efficiency. Now let us solve the problem. The electric field of linearly polarized EM wave given by EI is equals to AX E0 X comma Y e to the power minus J beta Z is incident upon a linearly polarized antenna whose electric field polarization can be expressed as EA is equals to AX cap plus AY cap ER theta phi. Question is, find polarization loss factor. Okay, so this is the electric field for the linearly polarized EM wave. Of it is incident, so it is the incident wave, so it is the incoming wave EI, and it is incident upon a linearly polarized antenna whose polarization is given by this. So obviously it is from the transmitter antenna and it is on the receiving antenna. Okay, it is a linearly polarized wave of the incident wave, that is incident upon a linearly polarized antenna. So this is the receiver antenna polarization, this is the transmitter antenna polarization. Okay, so we need to find out its polarization loss factor. So for this incident wave, what is this rho w as we have specified here? This is for the incident, this is for the receiver. So what is this rho w? According to this expression, the direction is ax, and for the antenna, that is for the receiver, for antenna this rho a, it is, what will be that? Rho a is a unit vector, both of them are the unit vector. So here unit vectors are ax plus a1, these are the vectors. So we need to take out the unit vector from this. So what will be that? Vector by its magnitude. Unit vector will be vector by its magnitude, that is ax plus ay. So what will be this PLF? Rho w dot rho a mod square. So it is ax dot 1 by root 2 ax plus ay whole square. So it is coming out as half. This one will be 0, ax dot ay will be 0. So what will be this dv value? 10 log base 10 PLF, that is 10 log base 10 0.5. So it is coming out as minus 3 dB or minus 3, as we have specified here dB, so no need to write. Clear? So how we have specified? It is directly given that it is for the incident wave and this is for the antenna, receiving antenna. So we need to take out the vectors from the given direction. So for the first one, it is given in the x direction, it is given in the x and y. So obviously from that we need to take out the our match direction between this, matching between this transmitter and the receiver. Clear? Let us solve the second problem. A wave radiated by an antenna is traveling in the outward radial direction along the plus z axis. Outward radial direction, which is given by plus z. Its radiated field in the far field is described by its spherical component and its polarization is right hand, that is clockwise, right hand circularly polarized. This radiated field is impinging upon a receiving antenna whose polarization is also right-handed circularly polarized. and whose polarization unit vector is represented by EA is equals to A theta cap minus J of A phi cap E R theta phi. Find PLF. Just try to have a read on this problem. The wave is radiated by an antenna is traveling in the outward radial direction along the plus Z. So if we are having an antenna, so this wave is radiated radially outward, but the direction is given as plus Z. Direction is given as plus Z direction. Okay. Its radiated field in the far field is described by its spherical components. Some spherical components is there by which it can be described, and its polarization is right hand circularly polarized. Okay. So this radiated field which is observed at the far field region is right hand circularly polarized. So previously when we have seen that it is propagating in the minus Z direction, then right hand circularly polarized we have considered as plus phase difference, plus 90 or multiple of odd multiple of 90. Now it is plus Z direction, and also it says that right hand circularly polarized. Just try to think, this radiated field is impinging upon a receiving antenna whose polarization is also right hand circularly polarized. Obviously for have the better reception the polarization should be matched. So the receiving antenna is also right handed circularly polarized and whose polarization is given by this. But for the receiving antenna the waves are propagating in the plus Z direction. Sorry, for the transmitting antenna the waves are propagating in the plus Z direction. But the receiving and the transmitting antenna, both of them are right handed circularly polarized. Now we need to think, if the radiated field from the transmitter is along plus Z, then what will be the direction for the receiver? Obviously the opposite one. So we can say for the receiver, for the receiving antenna, it will be minus Z direction. But both of them should have the same polarization. So for the minus Z, we have seen earlier that the phase difference should be positive. So obviously for the plus Z, it will be negative, opposite one. So we need to go with that. So obviously if this is the case for the receiver, so the transmitter will also have the same case, but only the thing is that the direction is different, right? So this is the unit vector representation for the receiver. For the transmitter it will also have the same representation, but only the thing is that the direction is different. One is minus Z, one is plus Z, because both of them are right handed circularly polarized. Clear? So if we go with the solution, what we can say, the polarization of the right hand circularly polarized wave traveling along plus Z, which is given by rho W, and for the antenna it is given by rho A. Now for the receiver we know this is the state of polarization. So what will be this unit vector? A theta minus J of A phi by root 2. But what will be the situation for the transmitter? Transmitter is also having the same kind of polarization, that is right hand circularly polarized, but for the transmitter it is plus Z, for the receiver it is minus Z. So obviously for the transmitter it will be the opposite of this. So what does it mean? It will be A theta plus J of A phi by root 2. So just try to think how we have been determined. This is the situation for the receiver. This is the situation for the receiver. The transmitter is also having the same situation, but from the transmitter point of view, it is going out of the transmitter. But for the receiver point of view, it is coming towards the receiver. So one is going out and there is coming towards. So obviously the situation will be opposite. This is the unit vector representation for the receiver, which is coming towards the receiver. So obviously for the transmitter, which is going out of that transmitter, it will be the opposite one. So that is the transmitter. Any doubt on this? Anyone having any doubt? So obviously both of them are having the same polarization, right-handed circular polarized. So obviously the PLF will be 0 dB, right? PLF will be 1 because this chi P is 0, right? So let us find out this PLF. Rho W dot rho A mod square. So this rho W is A theta plus J of A phi by root 2 dot A theta minus J of A phi by root 2 whole square. So this is 1, this is JJ, it is minus 1, minus minus plus, so it will be 1, right? Root 2 is 2, so 2 by 2, it is 1. So if we find out PLF in dB, it will be 0. So there is no mismatch between the transmitter and the receiver because they have already specified that both of them are having the same polarization. Clear? Any doubt on this? You need to think, what is the polarization? Either it is for the transmitter, either it is for the receiver. You need to think about that. Any doubt on this? Up to this? Anyone? Any confusion? Clear? Okay, I am concluding up to this for today.